This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Atlantic U-boat campaign of World War I, sometimes called the First Battle of the Atlantic, in reference to the World War II campaign of that name, was the prolonged naval conflict between German submarines and the Allied navies in Atlantic waters, the seas around the British Isles, the North Sea and the coast of France. Initially, the U-boat campaign was directed against the British Grand Fleet. Later, U-boat fleet action was extended to include action against the trade routes of the Allied powers. This campaign was highly destructive, and resulted in the loss of nearly half of Britain's merchant marine fleet during the course of the war. To counter the German submarines, the Allies moved shipping into convoys guarded by destroyers, blockades such as the Dover barrage and minefields were laid, and aircraft patrols monitored the U-boat bases. The U-boat campaign was not able to cut off supplies before the U.S. entered the war in 1917, and in later 1918, the U-boat bases were abandoned in the face of the Allied advance. The tactical successes and failures of the Atlantic U-boat campaign would later be used as a set of available tactics in World War II in a similar U-boat war against the British Empire. Contents 1. 1914, initial campaign 11 first patrols 12 first successes 13 end of the first campaign 2. 1915, war on commerce 21 first attacks on merchant ships 22 unrestricted submarine warfare 3. 1916, in support of the High Seas Fleet 4. 1917, renewed unrestricted campaign 5. 1918, final year 6 table 7 see also 8 notes 9 references 1914, initial campaign. This section needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. August 2011. Learn how and when to remove this template message. First patrols on 6 August 1914, 2 days after Britain had declared war on Germany, the German U-boats U-5, U-7, U-8, U-9, U-13, U-14, U-15, U-16, U-17, and U-18 sailed from their base in Heligoland to attack Royal Navy warships in the North Sea in the first submarine war patrols in history. The U-boats sailed north, hoping to encounter Royal Navy squadrons between Shetland and Bergen. On 8 August, one of U-9's engines broke down and she was forced to return to base on the same day. Off Fair Isle, U-15 sighted the British battleships HMS that submarines were no great danger to surface warships. First successes on 5 September 1914, U-21 commanded by Lieutenant Otto Herzing made history when he torpedoed the Royal Navy light cruiser HMS. 3 weeks later, on 15 October, Wettingen also sank the old cruiser HMS. Loss of 547 of her crew. The C&C Channel Fleet, ADM Sir Lewis Bailey, was criticized for not taking proper precautions during the exercises, but was cleared of the charge of negligence. Bailey later served with distinction as commander of the anti-submarine warfare forces at Queenstown. 1915, war on commerce first attacks on merchant ships. The first attacks on merchant ships had started in October 1914. On the 20th of October, SS. On 30 January 1915, U-20, commanded by Kapitänleutnant Otto Drascher, torpedoed and sank the steamers SS. A Belgian relief ship, was sunk on 7 May. U-20 sank RMS Princess Louise. Also in July, U-36 was sunk by the Q-ship Prince Charles, and in August and September U-27 and U-41 were sunk by Barralong, the former in the notorious Barralong incident. There were, however, no means to detect submerged U-boats, and attacks on them were limited to efforts to damage their periscopes with hammers and dropping guncotton bombs. Use of nets to ensnare U-boats was also examined, as was a destroyer, Starfish, fitted with a spar torpedo. In all, 16 U-boats were destroyed during this phase of the campaign, while they themselves sank 370 ships totaling 750,000. No U-boat patrols anywhere near the battle area. A further series of operations, in August and October 1916, were similarly unfruitful, and the strategy was abandoned in favor of resuming commerce warfare. 1917, renewed unrestricted campaign. Further information, convoys in World War I. In 1917, Germany decided to resume full unrestricted submarine warfare. It was expected to bring America into the war, but the Germans gambled that they could defeat Britain by this means before the U.S. could mobilize Likewise, German planners estimated that if the sunk tonnage exceeds 600,000 tons per month, Britain would be forced to sue for peace after 5 to 6 months. In February 1917, U-boats sank over 414,000. Were destroyed in the waters around Britain, compared to 9 the previous quarter, and 4 for the quarter before the campaign was renewed. As the campaign became more intense, it also became more brutal. 1917 saw a series of attacks on hospital ships, which generally sailed fully lit, to show their non-combatant status in January, HMHS. In January, 6 U-boats were destroyed in the theater. This also became the average loss for the year. The Allies continued to try to block access through the Straits of Dover, with the Dover barrage until November 1917 it was ineffective. Up to then just 2 U-boats had been destroyed by the barrage force, and the barrage itself had been a magnet for surface raids. After major improvement in the winter of 1917 it became more effective. In the 4-month period after mid-December 7 U-boats were destroyed trying to transit the area, and by February the high seas flotilla boats had abandoned the route in favour of sailing north about round Scotland, with a consequent loss of effectiveness. The Flanders boats still tried to use the route, but continued to suffer losses, and after March switched their operations to Britain's east coast. Other measures, particularly against the Flanders flotilla, were the raids on Zeebrugge and Ostend, an attempt to blockade access to the sea. These were largely unsuccessful. The Flanders boats were able to maintain access throughout this period. May 1918 saw the only attempt by the Germans to muster a group attack, the forerunner of the Wolf Pack, to counter the Allied convoys. In May, 6 U-boats sailed, under the command of K.L. Rucker in U-103. On the 11th of May, U-86 sank one of a pair of ships detached from a convoy in the Channel, but the next day an attack on the troop ship RMS Artillery. Since the siege of Fort Texas in 1846 and one of 2 places in North America to be subject to attack by the Central Powers, the other was the Battle of Ambos Nogales that was allegedly led by 2 German spies on the 11th of November 1918. World War I ended. The last task of the U-boat arm was in helping to quell the Wilhelmshaven Mutiny, which had broken out when the High Seas Fleet was ordered to sea for a final, doomed sortie after the armistice. The remaining U-boats joined the High Seas Fleet in surrender, and were interned at Harwich. Of the 12.5 million tons of Allied shipping destroyed in World War I, over 8 million tons, two-thirds of the total, had been sunk in the waters of the Atlantic War Zone. Of the 178 U-boats destroyed during the war, 153 had been from the Atlantic forces, 77 from the much larger High Seas flotillas, and 76 from the much smaller Flanders Force. Table date: ships sunk. HSF tonnage: ships sunk. Flanders tonnage: U-boats destroyed. HSF U-boats destroyed. Flanders 1914 3 2,952 N A N A5 N A1915 390 7,782 131 90,285 11 2 1916 350 508,745 512 644 151 7 1 2 1917. Not recorded. 2,895,983. Not recorded. 1,607,389 29 31 1918 435 1,044,822 327 558,760 25 31. See also: Mediterranean U-boat Campaign, World War I U-boat Campaign, World War I. Notes: Carrot, Gibson and Prendergast, 2002, p2. Carrot, Messimer, Dwight R., 2002. Verschalen, World War I U-boat Losses, Naval Institute Press, p. Atlantic Run, The Royal Canadian Navy and the Battle for the Convoys, Vanwall Publishing, 2006. Carrot, Tarrant, 1989, p24. Carrot, McKee, Fraser M., An Explosive Story, The Rise and Fall of the Depth Charge, in the Northern Mariner 3, No. 1, January 1993, pp46. Citing a letter by Stanley M. Woodward. Carrot, Halpern, 1995, pp 438-441. References: Gray, Edwin, 1972, The Killing Time, The U-Boat War, 1914-18, London, Seeley. ISBN